Greetings everyone. Today we are going to talk about pathology series, and in it we are going to particularly talk about portocaval shunt. That what it is, how it is made, what is its functions, and what are its clinical importance, and what are its non-clinical importance, and how and which veins are basically comprising, and they collectively form a shunt which is portocaval shunt or portovenous shunt. So portocaval shunt is basically a connection between portal vein and inferior vena cava. Function is basically to reduce portal hypertension, and it's also basically a connection that is going to be occur in between the veins. So in our body, in abdomen, when we particularly talk about abdomen, so we have two basic types of circulation. One is portal venous system and one is systemic. So portovenous system, basically we say that it is a system which starts from venules in the same way it ends at venules. So those type of systems we say we have portovenous system. So in our body, talking about first the systemic system, how it is made. So it starts from venules. At first we have middle and inferior rectal vein, venules. Then we have middle and inferior rectal vein, small veins, first venules, then small vein. Then we have internal iliac vein, which is large. Then after that we have common iliac vein, which is largest. And after common iliac vein, we have inferior vena cava, which is also largest. So here we have systemic circulation. Portocaval is quite different. At first we have superior rectal plexus, venules, then we have superior rectal veins, then inferior mesenteric vein, then superior mesenteric vein, and just in front that we have splenic vein for spleen and hepatic vein, which ultimately going and form a shunt with inferior vena cava. So we developed a shunt in that, and at this point we have sinusoid. We have a separate lecture on histology of liver, in which we are going to discuss a single functional unit, which is hepatic lobule, in detail its histology. That we have central vein, we have hepatic lobules, and in that we have sinusoids. What are the supply and what are the role of that lobule in a liver? Like kidney, we have a nephron as a functional unit. In liver, we have hepatic lobule as a functional unit. So separate lecture for discussing the histology of that hepatic lobule. We are returning to our original topic, portocaval shunts. So these are basically the composition of systemic and porto system, and this is how this shunt is going to be developed. But there is a one important point that we have. In portal or portal system is basically for the supply of GI, basic gastrointestinal, and its derivatives, while systemic is basic for extraintestinal supply. Which are extraintestinal? Like gastro extraintestinal tract, like includes genital system. So here we have a focus. Here we have to focus on one point. Whenever we develop a metastasis of GI tract, we often see it first metastasize the liver. While its opposition, when we have a metastasis of urinary tract infection, so these sites of metastasis are basically going to be first occur in our lungs. So we say these, from these points we will differentiate that either they are systemic or they are from portal system. Now talking about the three clinical important portocaval shunts. So first is going to be developed at rectal mucosa from systemic side, middle and inferior rectal vein, and from portal side, superior rectal vein. So we have a major clinical important at this point, and basically seen with patient having chronic liver diseases and hemorrhoids. Second major portocaval shunt or clinically important point we have that in the is at umbilicus between pre-umbilical vein and anterior abdominal vein. So we have dilated venules appearance, and we says that these are capid medusa because their shape is just like a cap, and medusa is basically a queen which is wearing a cap on which a snake shape is going to be developed. So from that we develop a name capid medusa. So these are dilated veins around that umbilicus that is going to be developed. At esophageal mucosa, there is third clinical important point. From systemic epigastric vein, from portal accessory hemiazygous vein. So shunt is going to be developed, and we've seen dilated vein in lower esophageal varices. So 3 to 4 non-clinical important points are basically kidneys, around ovaries and testes, spines of lumbar vertebra, and bare area of liver. And these are non-clinical important anastomosis that are going to be developed due to this in body. So these are basic our lecture on portocaval shunt, its pathology, that what are its clinical importance, what are its non-clinical importance. In this series, next lecture will be on liver cirrhosis and chronic liver diseases. So in this portocaval shunt, in quick overview, I quickly tell you that we discuss that what it is, and what is the purpose of developing this, how it is going to be developed in our body, what are the parts of it, and what are its clinical importance, what is its non-clinical importance. So till here, I just say that don't forget to subscribe Medicos Lectures by Shujaat, and stay tuned with me for clinical biochemistry series as well as on this pathology series. Thank you so much.